अगर जनरल इंजीनियरिंग. टाइम टेकन बाय ऑडिटर टू रीच अ डिसीजन इट टेक्स 1 मंथ. व्हेन वी गेट द रिव्यूज देन वी टेक अराउंड 1 मंथ टू डिसाइड दैट दिस पेपर कैन बी एक्सेप्टेड और नॉट. एटमोस्ट 1 मंथ. इवन दिस इज अ टास्क ऑफ मे बी फ्यू आवर्स बट बिकॉज पीपल आर बिजी कॉन्फ्रेंसिस प्रोफेशनल एक्टिविटीज टीचिंग रिसर्च मास्टर्स पीएचडी स्टूडेंट्स नो फंडिंग ट्रेवलिंग ऑल आउट ऑफ थिंग्स. सो ऑलमोस्ट दिस इज द यू नो एक्सपीरियंस. Some like IEEE, elsewhere, Springer, we are not paid. But some journals pay, like ITRI, ETRI, Korean journal, they pay for that. I am the reviewer of that, they pay for the paper review. But IEEE, elsewhere, Springer, they don't pay for that. Right? This is a contributory job, it's a contribution. It's a volunteer. We work as a volunteer. And the time taken by authors to revise the paper, they give you, once you get the revision on your paper, they give you 1 month to 3 months. Like I have the paper on revision. I got, I think, for one paper 1 month and another paper I got 3 months. Within 3 months, I have to submit that paper. Otherwise, it will be discarded from the database. They will not accept it again. And time taken by second review process, 1 month to 3 months. Okay. Then you will submit your paper after revision. Then it will take 1 month to 3 months more. For example, you have a major revision. Reviewer give you comment of major revision. Okay, and you revise the paper, and you revise the paper in 3 months, and you resubmit it to the editor in chief. Then he will again review your paper because it was major revision. Then he will give you comments in 1 to 3 months. But normally, re-review is a little bit fast because our reviewer already read your paper, so he just want to see that what you have done against his claims or comments. You ask a good question. It's happening. You know how it happens. When I for example, I am the editor in chief. Okay, I give you review to review the paper. Okay, you reviewed it and give back the comments. Okay, I gave it to author. Author revised the paper and give back to me. And then I again send to you. But you are very busy. You are not replying or you have some other problem. Then you are not doing. Then what I will do? I will give this paper to other related people. This is a new starting point. So it could take this upon your luck. I am telling you, this is upon your luck. This paper acceptance and rejection, sometimes you know it's upon your luck. Sometimes you know how lucky you are, it depends, and maybe your prayers are also there. Sometimes you know it works. And time taken by publisher after acceptance to generate proofs. When your paper is accepted, now publisher elsewhere will make your paper in the same format. Science Direct, they will put logo and the format of that. It will take around 2 months to 6 months. Normally elsewhere is very efficient. Springer is, they are very efficient. They, within 1 to 2 months, they do this thing. I have the experience. I get the proof from them 2 months like this or 1 month like this, normally. Time taken between proof and publication up to 1 year. When proof is ready, now it will take long time because there are so many papers in the queue. This is the very, very annoying time. When your paper is accepted, everything is okay. You are just waiting that it will be published. It is online, in Science Direct, online. Online version on the sciencedirect.com. And elsewhere, but it will be published after 1 year or maybe 6 months or 4 months because there are a lot of couple of papers in the queue. Editor in chief wants to publish them before. This is annoying process. Yeah, they tell. Like my paper in DSP and elsewhere, they accepted in May and they told me that they will publish in January 2010. So then they estimated. First they told me in December, but they regretted because they say that there is a special issue, we want to publish it before. So we want to move your paper to January issue. I said no problem. It's okay. It's a normal practice, but come late, but come good is better. And typical referee report. This is, I was talking that what referee wants in a paper. This is a very important thing. This presentation is available. You can see in the detail and you see every aspect that what are the, checklist which we require for when we review a paper. Is the topic important and relevant to publication, for publication, yes or no? When we are reviewing a paper, we are giving a checklist, then we have to tick. And upon that, our evaluation and this checklist, that we decide that this paper will be accepted or not. Editor decides that this paper can be accepted or not. Is the work presented in the manuscript new and original? So whatever the work you are presenting is new or original, has novelty. Are the references adequate and appropriate? Normally we get this kind of also that references are old or it's not adequate, so it's also very important. Does the manuscript uses appropriate language and style? Sometimes poor English, especially papers which are coming from the eastern part of the world. sometimes China, Korea, maybe Japan, English is poor, or maybe third world countries also, because we have to difficulty of understanding what they are saying. It's also we have to see that English is also okay or not, and style. Is the title of manuscript appropriate? Like I told you, title is the very important thing. It entices, attracts the reader. Is the abstract adequate to reflect the content of manuscript? Is the introduction adequately developed? Is the problem described in the manuscript clearly stated? Is the adopted methodology described sound and justifiable? You see the checklist, so many yes or no, then you decide that this paper is good or not. This is the criteria of evaluating a method. And normally journals are different. IEEE is different. When we review paper, the manuscript central opens a very long, like this, yes or no, you have to, there are radio buttons, there are checking, boxes, you have to check and you have to select that. So there are these are the evaluation criteria in all the journals. And then you give suggestions to the author, what should he improve in the paper. This is the suggestion, you give the suggestion, okay, you improve this thing, this part is weak, you do this thing, and how this variable is working, I cannot understand, like this kind of stuff. And then you give recommendations to the editor, that this paper can be published as it is. This is very rare. This is very lucky person whose paper is in this category. And second is published with corrections as recommended. This is called minor revision. There are something which should be modified or improved. This is minor revision. This is also very good thing. If you get this thing, then you are lucky. It means that your paper has maybe 80% chances it will be accepted. Minor revision. If it has minor revision. And return to the writer to be completely reworked and rewritten. Then it will be re-reviewed. If referee gives you this comment, return to writer to be completely reworked and rewritten, it means that your paper is major review. And it will go again for review and it will take a lot of time, a couple of months like this. And rejected is rejected. There is zero. Digital logic. You have got nothing. Then now you read the comments and you improve your paper and resubmit it to other place or maybe same journal. Okay, so this is the basically a checklist which is normally given to the referees or reviewers, and then we evaluate the papers upon this base. And venues of research publication, many people are familiar with this, that IEEE is the most prestigious in electrical and electronics engineers. We want to publish, everybody wants to publish paper in transactions. It's the biggest and the most prestigious society in the world. Elsevier is the most prestigious and biggest publisher with more than 2,000 journals in the world. It's a very big. I like